In this video, we're going to show how to calculate your marks. And we're going to use the variables and operators like multiply and addition. So in part one, we're going to show how to calculate your marks. And then in part two, we're going to show how you can add your grade. So here is part one. So let's look at data where there's variables and operators, where we have the normal plus, minus, multiply, divide by, and also other green blocks. So we're going to start off making a variable. So we've got three pieces of work that's marked. We've got coursework, midterm exam, and final exam. So we're going to create the variable, use make a variable, and then we're going to set it to the mark that we get. So we can use the set to block, and when there's a drop down menu, we're going to change the first one to coursework. We create a second one, this has midterm. We're going to enter a score there, let's say 81. And finally, we're going to create a variable for the final exam. So we type that in as a variable name. And we need to set that. Remember, drop down box. And then give that a value. So this is the marks for the final exam. So now we need to calculate things. So we're going to use the operators. So in this example, we're going to use coursework is 30%, midterm is 30%, final exam is 40%. So we can multiply coursework by 0.3, 30%, and midterm will be the same, 0.3, 30%, and final exam will be 0.4, 40%. So now we go back to variable, we can choose the variables for coursework, the blocks, for midterm, and for final. So you can see here, we just drag them into the side of the green block that's relevant for our maths. And we can add more than one. We can put green blocks inside other green blocks. So here we're going to add all of these together. So we use an add block for coursework and midterm. And then we need to put all of that inside yet another green block, plus, where we're going to add the coursework and midterm to the final exam. You have to mess about with it a little bit because the blocks do come out. So you see here, we've got an add block. One side, we've got the coursework and midterm, and the other side, the final exam. So we want to show the answer, so we can create another variable, which is going to be the total score, if you like. We're going to call that marks. So our marks variable, we're going to set it to all of the operators and variables that we've calculated the final score. So we're going to add the when green flag clicks from events, and it calculates a score. We can't really see that well, it is there. So let's just make the cap say the marks when we finish. Here we go, 78.4. So we know our maths works, so we want the person, the user, to enter the grades rather than have them in the blocks of code. So we need to ask the user, what did you get? What mark did you get for your coursework? What mark did you get for your midterm? And what did you get for your final exam? So in the sensing blocks, we have ask and wait, and then we can type our question into that block, as you see. So then the person is going to answer that, type in the answer, and we want the answer to go into the coursework. You can see there's an answer block also in sensing. So we can test that. We'll get the same answer as before. So here we're going to enter 75 and then run that, and then it should give us the same score. Let's try that again. So enter 75, run that, and the blocks weren't connected. That's why it wasn't showing us the score. So I have to make sure the blocks are connected, and here we have the correct score. So remember, when you keep separating the blocks, make sure they're back together again properly. One thing we need to think about is what happens when a person puts in a score that's not correct. They make a mistake. So when you ever get a value from a user, you may have to think, well, what happens if they make a mistake? So here we're just going to put in -1 as an example. So here we've got a score that's not correct, and here we've accidentally put 750 in rather than 75. So again, we can't get a score over 100%, so that's also a problem. So we can fix that problem by trying to make sure that the user puts in a correct value. So in the control, there are several blocks, and there's one called repeat until. So what we want to do, we want to try to make sure the user puts in a value between 0 and 100. So although you would normally use less than and equal to and greater than and equal to, we don't have that in Scratch. We're just going to show you less than and greater than. So we want a score that's greater than -1 and a score that's less than 101. It's not precise, but we're just given an example of how to create the blocks together. So here we've got the operators again. We've got greater than and less than, green blocks. We're putting a coursework in. And as we said, greater than -1 and less than 101. Now in the green blocks, we've got something called a Boolean. We've got and, or, and not. An and means that both parts of it have to be correct. So we want to make sure coursework is less than 101, and we want to make sure coursework is greater than -1. So we can put those two blocks together in an and block, and then put that inside the repeat until block. So that checks that both are correct. So when the user puts in a mistake, then it ignores that and it keeps repeating until the value is entered between 0 and 100. So it's always good to test it. So let's try the -1. When we enter that, it does nothing. So let's put another value in. Try that. 110. Didn't work. 750. Again, you can see that it didn't take the error. Now we put 75 in, now it's worked correctly. So it didn't work when there was an error, but it did work when it was correct. So we want to do that with the three values that the user is going to enter. So we have to do it with the coursework, we have to do it the midterm, and we have to do it the final exam. So when you're writing programs, if you're using Scratch with blocks or any other programming language, you have to make sure when a user enters something that you deal with errors. That's a part of programming. So now we're just going to go through all the repeat blocks to make sure we've got the coursework, the midterm, and the final correct. So we just need to change some of the values. So we've got the actual variable blocks, we've got the question that still has coursework in at the moment, we need to change that as well, and the set block has to be changed. So now we've got the variable blocks changed, let's change the question at midterm. You may need to do some testing with different figures. Test your error handling, how you make sure errors are handled correctly. but you might want to check to see if the maths is correct. So you might use a spreadsheet with these numbers in to make sure that the answer's correct. Scratch is not really built to do mathematics. Now, we've got set coursework, set midterm, and set final exam. So we're going to give them values outside the range we want. So when we run the program previously and we've got a valid number, a valid score, it's not going to use the old score. So you see the variables keep the same value when you run the program. So to stop that happening in Scratch, we're just going to set all the variables to -1. So at the start, we know that it's going to need new scores entered. So they're all -1. So now we put in the scores. So we put in 78 rather than 79. So it's a slightly different score than previously. But that's okay, we're just using numbers for testing to see if it works. So we can try different numbers. So here we've got scores just over 50, and that's great. There's our grades and scores calculated correctly. Now let's add the grades in part 2. Well, we have our correct total score, and now we want to add the grades that these represent. So is it an A, a B, a C, a D, an F, or we also have B+, C+, D+. So a score of 50 and above is a pass. Anything below will score an F. So we're going to use a series of if else blocks. In Scratch there's just this option of true or false, so we're going to have to use if else blocks inside each other. So there's different ways of doing this. We're going to use the less than route. So if something's less than 50, if the marks are less than 50, your grade is going to be an F. Now if it's not less than 50 and it's less than 55, it will be a D. So we can use less than in intervals of 5 and then carry them up to 80, and if you don't get less than 75 but you do get less than 80, then that's going to be a B+. Above that is going to be an A. So you can see here we're going to use the duplicate quite a lot because we're using if else blocks inside if else blocks, and there's going to be quite a few. So here we've got less than 55 is going to be a D because we know it's not less than 50. So once we create those two blocks, we can duplicate them. So now we've got 4 if else blocks, one inside each other. So we've got 50, 55, 60 and 65, and now we're going to duplicate all of them. So now we've got 8 blocks inside each other, and that's going to go up from 50 up to 80. So count them up. We'll do the numbers first, and then we're going to change what grade they are. So once we get up to 80, we know we are less than 80 is going to be a B+, and if it's not less than 80, then it's going to be an A. So our final block, we actually use the else part as the grade, not just another if else block. So as you can see, we've just used blocks inside each other. So now we need to change the grades. So hopefully if we go from A to B+, to B, to C+, to C, to D+, to D, that should work out correctly. Remember, we're going to test. It's a good idea to make sure your program works with different numbers to make sure your blocks do calculate the correct score and the correct grade. So although there's a lot of blocks, with the duplicate With duplication, it's quite easy to create all of these. Doesn't take too long. Okay, so you can see what we've done there. We've just used if-else blocks inside if-else blocks to work out the grade. So now we're going to test it. We can enter in now marks for coursework and midterm and final exam. So we enter them. Now we've got our final score and our grade as well. So let's make that larger so you can see it better. So let's see if we can get a D grade. So our score is just above 50. That's correct total score, and the grade is D. Try another one. You can see our variables go back to minus one, and then we're going to put the scores in. So let's just use a random scores. Here our total is 73.8, which is a B. So you can test different scores to make sure the grade is correct. You may use a spreadsheet if you need that help. And here's the blocks. There's quite a lot. So one way you can separate the blocks, for example, is using the events. Instead of when green clicked, you can have a message. So you send a message, and then once that's received, then it runs those blocks. So here we're just going to use message one, the default. So we broadcast message one at the end of the blocks, and then when received, we'll run the grade blocks to calculate the grade. So it does exactly the same thing. So we test it again, make sure it's still working. Here we've just got 50, that's correct, grade is D. So that's just a way of separating our blocks. We'll cover the broadcast block in more detail in another video. But for now, that's us finished. So thanks for watching, and as always, if you haven't before, please subscribe. Okay, see you for the next video.